Good afternoon, to doctors and friends. Today, I want to discuss about the education psychology. One of the theory of education psychology is metacognitions. What is metacognitions? Metacognition is somebody thinking what they think, or the students must think about what they learning in the class. Then the ideas. Okay, the ideal resource is get from the strategies. You have to know how to think about metacognitions. Okay, follow the strategies. And the students need to have a self-regulation, memory, and study skills. According to the John Frewer, metacognitions is the heightened awareness of one's thought process. It seems like thinking about thinking. The John Frewer says, metacognitions refers to higher order thinking, which involves activities, awareness, and control over the cognitive process engaged in learning. It means the students need to use the metacognitions to think deeply for what they learn at the times. Here is a framework of metacognitions knowledge. According to the frameworks, frameworks will give the metacognition to the three parts. The first part is strategic knowledge. Strategic knowledge is one's own abilities for using strategies to learn information. That is means we use their abilities to learn and to think about the knowledge they want to know, or in the information they want to know. The second part is a personal knowledge. Personal knowledge is understanding one's own capabilities. It means the students must to know what they have had to think in the subject they learn, or the knowledge they need to get from and followed by the capabilities. And the third one is task knowledge. Task knowledge is how one perceives the difficulty of the task. They think that something's work is difficult. To not understand. They need to use their own thinking to solve the problems. Then we can look at the metacognition strategies. Metacognition strategies will have five parts. The part one is directed attention. And the directed attention, the students will focus on the material used by the teacher. Example, the teachers will use the photo or the pictures to teach them, and then they will look at the photo or pictures to know what the teachers want to give them to learn, and then think about the source in the photo and the pictures. The second one is the selective attention. Selective attention is to give the student to prepare the speech in advance in relation to pronunciations, intonations, and expressions. It means give them to learn what they want to learn. Example for the pronunciation or intonations or expression, to give them to learn and to choose to select which one they want. The third one is the self-management. Self-management is to help the students to measure activities and practice some activities to develop their speaking skills. The students want to give the question or the answer need to think how they give the answer clearly and correctly. This is a self-management. That is for students to think about the answer or the question they want to ask. Okay, they want to give. The fourth is self-monitoring. Self-monitoring allows the student to know the pronunciation, grammar, vocabulary, and accuracy that are important components in order to develop speaking skills. It means when they want to give the answer or want to ask the questions, they need to think the question and the grammar is more clearly to give them to give the teachers or the other person to understand what they want to tell. And the last one is a self-evaluation. Evaluation is to permit students to evaluate their speaking skills through conversations, amongst them to make a conscious about their progress skills. It means the students will evaluate themselves about the speaking, what they're talking about, and then what they Okay, to the other person. And then all the speakings of the radiate is from their mind, not for the information from other people. Okay, here is the step for the learning, how the students learn the metacognitively. Okay, followed by the pictures in the books. And then the students will follow the books, follow the picture to give question or to give the skill to speak what they want to know or what they want to tell. Lesson planning with metacognition in mind. This one is for the teachers. The teachers, how to give the student use the metacognition to think in the class. One of the most effective way to teach metacognitive strategies is the think aloud strategy. This means they need to think themselves. Then to give, the teachers must to give the students to think themselves about the information or about the pictures or photo the teachers give. And the second one is that this involves a teacher talking the class from her key as she tackles the task, give the task, and like a piece of the test with new vocabulary or a new main concept. Example, okay, the teachers can have in the class, you'll give something idea to the students first, and then the students need follow the what the information teacher gives to think more or to see more or okay, give the new idea to the teachers. That is a metacognitive. That is the thinking what they think or the thinking about the information received from the teachers. They need to think deeply. Planning for the metacognition. Okay? The teachers need to follow the 5 steps for the planning for metacognition. The first is the teachers need to consider the bigger pictures. What progress in understanding of skills do you hope to see or the student hope to see? Okay, the first is the teachers need to give some photo or some pictures, and then the student will see the photo or pictures and then think what they want to know in the pictures or the photo. The second one is how do you return the space list over a series of lessons. Then the teachers want to give the times, give the series for the lessons to give the student to up their questions and up their answer what they're thinking about. The third is what is your objective for a single lesson? And then the teacher must think what objective they need to achieve. Example, they need the teacher, they need the students to achieve their thinking process, or they want to achieve their good result in the examinations. Example, this is what is your objective for the single lesson for the third part. And the fourth is, what are the most appropriate metacognitive strategies to support? Okay, then teachers also need to think about appropriate metacognitive strategies to support the students, to give students have more information about the theory metacognitive, and then to give them how they want to think and think more. Okay. The 5 is how will you measure and positive feedback? Then the teachers must think what is the positive, what is the optimist process or the impact to the students when they use the metacognitive. This question is to give the teachers to think how they want to carry out theory metacognition in the class. The teachers have to prepare 5 questions, these 5 questions to prepare their planning lessons. Okay, then here is a method of teaching in class. And then when the teachers thinking about the 5 questions, they will follow the 5 questions to give the example, to give the some theory to things like the students. Example, okay, when the teachers ask the student or give the task, is that Mason and Jasmine, okay, example questions here, that Mason and Jasmine have 5 pounds between them. Mason have 90 pounds more than Jasmine. How much money does Jasmine have? Then the students will receive this task and then they will keep thinking for the metacognitions. Example, my knowledge of myself, get my knowledge of myself from their own. The knowledge from their own, get to start the thinking. And the task is what do I know about this type of problem? And then the student different ways of that. It means the students will use their own strategies to solve the max problem, for example. And then the meta-cognition question will change to, will translate to cognition. It means the student start to think about the, what they know, what the words meaning in the question, and then change the word to the equation, okay, to the equation, and use the equation to get the answer. Okay, when the answer is get, when prove the conditions, get the question back to the meta condition again to give the students can have to know what method they want to use to solve these mathematic problems. Example, they can use the algebraic expressions or use the get other formulas to think to solve the next problem. This is the meta condition, and then use their own thinking process to use their to carry out the strategies and solve the problem they meet now. Okay, when the metacognitions change to cognitions, the students will start to planning. Okay, what's the planning need to do is the then number one is I need to think about how we have done these problems before and choose the best strategy. This question will be invited to the team master. And okay, I know and start by writing out the problems as an outbreak proportion. So this is the planning for the students to know how to solve the problems. Okay, from planning, from the planning. We will ask okay, the questions about the thinking, what they want to solve the problem, and the best strategy to solve. Then, and the second one is that they have the answer to give the idea to solve this problem. That is followed by algebraic execution. And when through the condition, okay, the students will carry out other process to back to the meta conditions. Okay, for example, monitoring. Okay, the question is monitoring the student to ask them to answer the questions. Number one is, has this improved my understanding of the task? You think the emotion, the thinking can help, okay, can improve your understanding in the next question. And the second one is, yes, I know that like a type of problem. If further, we will summarize the questions. Okay, that means we will know how to make the question. The question is okay, from the thinking and solve the questions from them themselves. This is monitoring. Okay, this means the students will monitor by the okay, product from the condition and then answer the questions. The last one is okay, the student need to evaluation. Okay, evaluation. I need to think about how we have done these problems before and choose the best strategy. Okay, that means the students will know what they need to do after thinking and monitoring. They have to evaluate that skill is suitable or not for the answer. That is the evaluation for the students to think. So it means when the teachers prepare the theory for meta-cognitive to the students need to run in three steps. Okay, three steps. One is planning, one is monitoring and evaluation. Then before planning, the students need to use meta-cognitions to think the problems, to think the max problem first. And then doing the planning, okay, doing the planning, how to solve the problem. And then through the cognition, think the suitable step to collect the answer, to give the correct answer. And then the correct answer, okay, when they're thinking the formula, the students will monitoring the formula. And then think okay, how to improve the understanding for the students. And we have to know okay, which formula needs to use. The last thing is that they need to do evaluation. Is if the step is suitable to answer this question. And then they pick the best strategy to solve the problems. Okay? So before that, you can see that this is the planning for the summarize for the planning and evaluate. Okay, planning is analyze learning task, set goals and select strategies. It's the first step that students need to think how analyze the question and then set the goals and select the strategies suitable strategies to solve the problems. And the second second one is practice. The things monitoring, how to monitor those questions, and then give the correct answer to the teachers. Okay, and then the problems or the best strategies is the best strategies to choose, and then he will follow the strategies to think about the evaluate, to evaluate themselves, that the performance and effectiveness of strategies. This is the three way to get to achieve the process metacognitive. Lastly, this is my conclusion. From the conclusion, you can see metacognitive learning has brought a lot of positive impact because this skill allows students to compose their way of thinking first. That is by the students, the subject, how to attain metrics, how to attain methodology, and how to overcome obstacle and assess the results obtained. So this is the step planning. Okay, from the metacognition, the way of thinking first, have to thinking the question first. What is the question need the student to know, and then how to study the subject, and then attain the matrix, and how to attain the matrix, how to overcome, to solve the problem, to solve the question problems. The second one is, during this metacognitive skills, the teachers who teach the subject need to observe to the factors of the students. Metacognitive strategy along with the components that influence the existence of the metacognitive strategy, and consider the strategy so that the strategy can be better. The first conclusion is for the student, and we know how the student thinking about what they want to think or what they want to solve the problem. They use their own abilities to planning and to monitor. And lastly is evaluate. But for the teachers, mathematicians want to use the metacognitive in the class, they need to observe, the students, get what they want to get, what the influence for the students in the process of metacognition. And then give the best consider for the strategies so that the strategy can be better used in the student. This is what the teachers need to follow. Okay. And then this is my explanation for the metacognition. Thank you.